Hello, my name is Toby Flinch. I'm a photographer, videographer located in the DMV area. And in this video, I'm going to be taking you guys with me as I take photos for Howard University's Track and Field Media Day. And just like a little BTS type of thing. So can't wait to get to it. And I'll see you guys very shortly. Okay, so right now I'm getting ready for traveling with the track team tomorrow for the conference championships. And today I'm currently packing up all my stuff. Currently, I'm going to be charging my V-mount batteries, as well as just putting everything else where it needs to be. And so this is the FX6. I'm going to be shooting on this for majority of it for video. Right now, I've got a Sigma lens on there and a Tiffin ProMist filter, as well as just bringing stuff I might need, like my Tascam recorder, and my pro grade CF Express reader. So trying to be prepared and making sure everything is in the right spot. And let me show you my bag. So this is my cinema bag. It's a Themba cinema bag. And I'm gonna be using this to make sure I am just ready. I put nearly everything I can in here. And then I have a suitcase as well just to take my chargers as well as everything else. And one thing I try to do is just be over-prepared. Have as many cords and cables that I might need as possible. I never want to be in lack of charging capability. And right now I'm just watching some YouTubers, David Moorfield to be in fact. But overall, that's pretty much it. And I'm also going to be packing my DJI mic kit. This is like the first generation. Just to make sure I have everything I need. Just if I need to do a quick interview after a race, anything like that. And this is my bag with all my clothes. It's going to be a 3-day getaway. Essentially, I just threw a bunch of stuff in here. I'm also using the small rig 155 batteries. This one kind of has a weird thing on it where it doesn't really show me the percentage. But I'm taking it with me anyway. I have two of these. I'm going to be charging them now. And I don't really know what else I might be taking with me. If I feel like there's something I'm missing, I'll probably add it in later, but that's pretty much it. So in addition to that, I'll be using this Tamron 70-180, which is a new lens I got recently. And on my Sony a7 III, I really like the lens. It's great, but having used like better lenses, I know it's not the best, but it still does a lot of what I need it to do. And I love it. And I might also be taking this one with me too. This is a cute little gift I got from my girlfriend for Valentine's Day. So I might just bring it as a thing just to keep, just for fun. But this is gonna be my main lens for photos, like photography wise. And if I wanna get a little bit more photojournalistic, I might just take the Sigma lens off the FX6 and put it on here and try to get some photojournalistic type photos as well. So this is a video of me getting ready. It was actually snowing this day. I already had all my stuff packed and I had to get an Uber to campus because there was not gonna be anyone able to take me there. I couldn't just leave my car on campus because it would have gotten stolen or towed. So yeah, that was pretty much it. So I'm currently editing and my room is a snack room. So people keep on coming in and out, but right now it's pretty chill. And we were at an event earlier today where the athletes were getting recognized for being, you know, top in their events. So I took some photos of that. Also took some photos from my job with the MEAC conference. You know, just some general shots of other athletes as well. And pretty much that's it. Right now I'm just gonna edit some of the photos. Maybe put a mashup with some photos and videos just to recognize the athletes so that can go on the school page. And yeah, I really wish sometimes I had a second shooter with me. It would make me a lot more efficient. Someone who could just like cross shoot with me allows me to be just more efficient overall. But it is what it is. And currently gonna be putting all these out hopefully by tonight. So yeah, great first day. It's my first time doing this vlogging stuff consistently. So, can't wait to see what I do at the end of this. So this was a nice sunset. I was able to capture this to be able to add to the vlog, and it was a really good day after day two. So this is a video I made for the second day of track and field conference. And one thing I'm definitely gonna try and do is get rid of copyrighted music from my videos, because one thing I've noticed is that the NCAA track and field page, they no longer really collab with schools that use copyrighted music, and I want to be able to get the school more attention. So it's something I'm definitely gonna try and eliminate from my workflow completely and start trying to do more sound design as well as, you know, making my own soundtrack. And this is me, I think on the third day. So I was just going through my workflow. I was actually editing some photos I'd taken earlier that day and trying to get them all out to the athletes so they can be able to post them, use them, do whatever they want with them. So for the third day, I didn't really get to take a lot of BTS videos, but these are the photos I did take. So for some of the photos, I tried to take a top down shot, essentially just giving more isolation to the athletes and just being like trying different angles, because for track, there isn't too much you can really do in terms of being different. For the video, this was actually an idea from one of the athletes, Andre Prince. So shout out to Andre. He gave me this idea of a video we could do, and I really liked it, and it turned out pretty well.
Yes, they are the champs, the Howard Bison for 2024 for the indoor track season. They are the champs.
Set did it in 2022, 2023, and now three in a row in 2024.
Yeah, and that's consistency, and there's nothing like it.
He will take that title back to the district with him in 2024 as well as a team title for the third consecutive year.
Another one. DJ Khaled.
And I know that somebody's been praying for me. Head above ground and I could have been 6 feet deep. Out on these streets when I get down on my knees. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. I'm bloated bad for everybody who counting me out. And I still got love for all my dogs who holding me down. Head above ground for my downs and my downs. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. I done lost a few heartbreaks. Yo. Never lost a thing I can't replace. Couple times thought I wouldn't make it. Then I came up 10 toes out the basement. I done had to mute noise. Did a couple things that left me no choice. I done hit some licks that my mama won't be proud of. Said we gon' be rich, give us all she can smile for. The devil on the block and he lurking.
The wave was on our backs and we got it done.
So I'm currently making this as the end to the YouTube video I plan to make 2 weeks ago. I just want to say thank you guys for watching. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching me work and everything I've done. I know that it really wasn't the best video. I felt like I could have done more, but at the end of the day, I don't want to procrastinate enough and then push it back. I just want to give you guys what I worked on instead of just procrastinating and sitting on it. So I'm thankful for you guys watching this video. Can't wait to try and work on more in the future. I definitely need to get someone to help me because I'm not the most well-planned person when it comes to doing stuff like this, and I would definitely appreciate if someone was there to help me. So I'm gonna see about that in the future, and thank you. So I'll see you guys. Have a great one, and peace.